World Health Organization declares gaming addiction a mental illness. Video games make you go crazy? Fucking what? Look at all these articles. How many fucking outlets wrote about this? There are even videos. Fucking Christ. But what possible observable behavior could a psychologist have witnessed to lead them to this conclusion? What deviant action makes them believe that video games are a detriment to your mental health?
That's my girlfriend Alyssa, and today is a really special day for her. It's the 2-year anniversary of when she started her transition. So could I get a round of applause for her?
Hey, Games Done Quickly's back. Who doesn't love speedrunning? I do. I think we all do. And Games Done Quickly does it right. It ticks all the little boxes that you'd want it to tick. Awkward social interactions. Check.
So confirmed, Santa's number one helper is a squirrel.
I would really prefer if you would be quiet.
Brat fetishists sniffing the chairs of lonely girls that accidentally sit down next to them without a restraining order in place or a personal security guard? Check. Oh yeah, give it a sniffaroo. Ugh, savor the flavor. Every single year, I look forward to this because it is the most progressive, inclusive, safe atmosphere that you could want to get a world record in Zelda. Now, a lot of other events, they're not forward-thinking enough to take care of the needs of their community, but Games Done Quickly, they are. They go that extra step to ensure that everybody has a good time, because nothing says good time more than making sure people can't comment on any of their streams. Now, sure, some of you may be saying, hey, wait a minute, I'm not going to say anything offensive. I'm a PC kind of guy. Why can't I say something? We need to make sure that things are proper, even if that means occasionally the good guys can't get their message out. By the way, you can still meet. I need those pills. If you got the pills, meet me there. Now, in years past, people have been able to say some pretty offensive shit. Like, look at this guy. This guy right here. Can you believe he had an emoticon on his Twitch chat that was targeting these beautiful, brave butterflies? Can you believe that? Look at that asshole. Having a emoticon about himself, about something that he did that happened to be offensive to them. Fuck him. Get rid of him. Can't let people have Twitch emoticons that might offend you. It's part of the reason we ban the chat. Good times, open, inclusive, nobody can talk. And nobody can use an emoticon. Might be offensive. But even with all that, all the progress that we've made, people are still bringing their transphobia to this fucking event. And that's gotta stop, okay? That needs to fucking stop. I mean, look at this bigoted asshole.
First of all, the first question I've got, what got you into speedrunning, just in general? I always like to ask people that.
So, Cosmo Wright and Siglemic were my two, like, biggest inspirations speedrunning. Way back when, they were, like, in my eyes, the two big, like, giants, basically. Like, they were huge in the community. They were good at their games. It was really impressive to watch them.
Thanking Cosmo for getting him into this. First of all, don't dead name them. All right, everybody noticed. Look at these comments. Queer Queenie, okay, called you on your bullshit. Dead naming somebody. You did it intentionally. If you don't know who Narcissa, not Cosmo asshole, Narcissa Wright is, here they are talking about their transition.
I'm out of my fucking mind.
But this asshole, he's got to dredge up the past. What a dick. That's not something you make fun of. Maybe you haven't read the new policy that's in place. All right, there's a dilation schedule now. Because sometimes, when you're going for that Zelda world record, you gotta cough up a hairball. But no, he's gotta be one of those guys that shows up to the event and just ruins it for everybody. Doesn't even read the fucking policy. The dilation policy. People are acting like this is something they're unfamiliar with. All right, it's right in the event rules. Dilation policy. But no, not that guy. Not Mr. Dead Name Him. Mr. Dead Name Beautiful and Brave Narcissa Wright. It's guys like this that have ruined the event for everybody. They've created a toxic atmosphere. It's even driven away the cosplayers. I have not seen Ben Franklin once this year. Just last year, hasn't even shown up again. All right, this kind of dickhead makes it impossible for knitting to get a round of applause anymore.
I believe your knitting deserves a great round of applause. Yeah.
That's right, you fucking hug her. She's a world-class knitter. Games Done Quickly is not meant for you to have fun, okay? Let me make that clear. You don't get to show up and sit on a couch and entertain people with a speedrun that's both informative and funny, cracking jokes with your friend, and all around having an enjoyable time. You're not forming memories here. We are making sure that this is an inclusive, safe space for the people that need it to be. So you take your racist apparel, okay, Mr. Mega Hat, and you go to another event. Games Done Quickly is about one thing and one thing only. Making some motherfucking money. How you doing there, chat? It's early morning in the Arctic hellscape known as the Midwest, with 45 bajillion degrees below zero Celsius, of course. You'll freeze to death even indoors with a fire going. So I thought I'd spend the last few moments of my life talking about dilation done quickly. It's funny how you're already getting 200 watchers at this time while Donga can't get more than 100 now. Streamy's not a bad little platform. I mean, there are people kind of just kicking around waiting to watch shit. I just think more people need to stream stuff. Aside from, like, Narcissa Wright. I don't even know if Cosmo still streams here. I think they might have been driven off by all the bad people that have come in. Is Narcissa still streaming on Streamy, or have they become one of the 47% now? Should I put up a little memorial image for Narcissa, or are they still among the living? No, Cosmo's gone, so they left then. You know, I thought we could talk about speedrunners. Just kill a little time. Maybe you're getting ready for work. Maybe you're going to go drive to work. Maybe you're like that one dude who's already at work. In which case, your boss is a faggot. Turn the volume up. But I thought we could talk about speedrunners. Kill a little time. I've got some lore to go with that. Maybe talk about like Chibi Neko Demics, the guy that cheated his way in Super Mario. I'm actually familiar with him. I knew him before he was in speedrunning. He's a weird little fucker. I've talked to him on Skype before, long, long fucking time ago. Dude used to wear dog collars and was into all sorts of weird fucked up shit. Or maybe watch some UltraJMan and play the clip where his mother smacks him like a bitch in front of the entire audience and you can hear him cry. That's a good clip too. There's lots of fun shit related to speedrunning and video games for an early fucking morning stream. Fucking freaks in the picture, Jesus, no, I'm sorry. You watch what you say. These are beautiful women. Each of them is a delicious diva. You need to get on your fucking knees and worship this trans pussy. Okay, this is what a real woman looks like. A real woman looks like Jesus Christ went bald. Like if you tip them upside down, you could mop a hallway with their head. That's what a real woman looks like. A real woman has a jaw that you could cut glass with. A real woman has biceps larger than a natural woman's head. A real woman has testicles. Okay, it's a new day and age. Get with it. Such bigotry in my chat, I can't take it. Alright, we're inclusive here. Diversity is our fucking strength. It's not a mantra, it's a lifestyle. So let's get some clips here. I'll watch some shit early in the morning. Kill a little bit of time before I get bored of this, and then I go play a video game. Well, what do we start with? I know I had this. No, that's... Okay, get slapped by his mother. That's a good one. Give me one moment, chat. And we will watch some shit.
A man has a choice.
No, that's not what I wanted. That's my own shit. I don't want to watch that. Okay, let's see here. I can turn that off. I think this is ready to go. Alright, let's display capture. Where are you here? There we go. There we go. Everything should be up on screen. Just have a sip of my drink here. And we'll listen to Speedrunner get slapped by his mother on livestream. UltraJMan. Very funny. Spurgs the fuck out. And mommy gives him a nice love tap on his face. Probably disappointed that he's like 30 years old playing fucking Rayman in the basement on a weekday rather than getting a job or going to school. I don't know. I couldn't tell you. Who's the balding bitch? Well, at least he used the proper pronoun. She is the balding bitch. Very lovely lady. I don't know what the name is. Letitia? Let's just say her name is Letitia. She seems like a Letitia to me. Okay, here we go. Is that work?
What a piece of shit. Look, he did it again. No, fucking, why do people tell me to fucking take a break when I'm doing good at games? You fucking shut your whore bag piece of shit cock-sucking mouths.
Ah, see, this is back from the good old days of everybody wanting to be the AVGN. So they all had to say, like, 38 cuss words in a row to really nail home that they're gamers, okay? This is what gamers do. We say naughty words while we play our video games. And he says it in such a nerdy way. Like, this is a guy that's not comfortable swearing. You ever hear somebody that swears and you can tell instantly from listening to them that they're not comfortable doing it? That's this guy. That's this guy to a T.
I need to restart again because I lost too many lives. I hit the continue button.
Good going, nerd.
I hit the continue button. I need to not hit the continue button. I need to game over first so I can actually continue from the start of the level.
Don't worry, Chad. It's coming.
Mm-hmm. Okay!
Don't you fucking raise your voice to me. What the fuck is wrong with you?
Slap me! Do it! Do it!
What is wrong with you?
Do it!
What is wrong with you?
Would you, you know, I love this situation because in my head, I like to imagine they live in the suburbs and his window's open and it's like summer and his neighbors are out mowing their lawn. Maybe the people across the street are having lemonade on their porch. And all of a sudden you hear this 30-year-old spurg out while he's playing Rayman screaming, slap me! Do it! Do it! Let's back that up. Listen to it one more time. The aggression, you can hear the soy dripping off his words as the anger creeps in.
I need to game over first so I can actually continue. From the start of the level.
Mm-hmm.
Okay!
Don't you fucking raise your voice to me. What the fuck is wrong with you?
Slap me! Do it! Do it!
What is wrong with you?
Do it!
What is wrong with you?
Do it!
You want me to fucking slap you? I will.
Do it! I don't care.
Knock it off. Don't you dare. Don't you dare. Fuck. Lot of fucking nerve. Never raise your voice to me again. Can you understand?
Yep.
Fucking stop it. God damn it, stop it.
Hold on. I need to stop the stream. I need to stop my stream, right?
Hold on one second, Father. I need to stop the stream or people are gonna think I'm a fucking lunatic. You can hear the physical confrontation start. You can actually hear the moment they come to blows in this fucking audio.
Raise your voice to me again! Can you understand?
Yep.
Fucking stop it! God damn it, stop it.
That sounded like a turkey gobbling. Let me back that up. Listen to it really, it sounds like a bird in distress.
Fucking stop!
That right there, that sound that she made. I'm wondering if he like punched her in the tit. How do you make a woman make that sound? I'm telling you, it's a turkey gobbling.
Again, can you understand?
Yep.
Stop.
I want that as a sound clip. I've never heard a human woman sound like a turkey gobbling before. But her son spurging out made that happen. It does, doesn't it? It sounds exactly like that. Oh, UltraJMan. I got another clip. Let me pull this up. Give me one second here. Put these beautiful ladies back up on screen. Let me find it. If you want to see what this handsome individual looks like, I've got one where he cries. He cries for like 5 minutes talking about how speedrunning saved his life. And people shit on him in the comments, and the people that put the video up got very fucking angry about that. Okay, I think I got it here. All right, let's dig into some more UltraJMan. Here we go.
So let's see here. It's time to.
That's the beautiful man himself. I don't know if my mouse is showing up on screen, but I'm pointing to the guy standing, the one who looks like a fucking a stand-in bass drummer for stand-in bassist for Pantera or something. He wanted to really desperately be in a hair metal band, but that time has passed, so he took up Let's Playing.
Like nervously tosses duct tape back and forth because that's like one of my quirks here, but Let's see, how do I start this story? Let's see.
Two guys walk into a bar.
You guys walked into the bar, no. About, I'd say, oh, I don't know, sometime years ago when I was like 10 or so, ended up being...
Does anybody notice how not one person in this fucking entire room, an entire room full of like 35 people, is looking at anybody else? There's no eye contact. Everybody is looking in a different direction. When you take a group of people that are this low T and you put them in a uncomfortable close situation, nobody can make eye contact. It's too spooky. So they're like looking at their shoes and looking at the arm of the sofa. One guy's looking at the wall. I'm sure a dude's counting how many panels are on the ceiling. But let's listen to this brilliant speech.
Being homeschooled and I didn't have a lot of friends or anything, so what I did instead is I spent a lot of time playing video games. That's about all I did. And right up until I got into high school, met one of my friends. That's like the thing I did. It's the thing I related with, and a lot of weird things that happened as a kid I'd rather not go into that made me really...
Somebody said the fat guy's looking at him. He was for a minute. I think he got confused and thought he had food in his hands. That's a hacky sack, though. You can see the defeated look as he looks down. He's almost downtrodden. Very sad. Like, oh, I thought that was food. But he's not holding food. That's an exercise device. I can't eat that.
Socially anxious and, hold on. So... Basically, where I'm going with this story is,
I like the musical choice in the background, too. It's very fitting. As a man breaks down in tears, talking about speedrunning fucking Rayman on the internet for people.
Online, around 2007 or so, I started to do Let's Plays, and, this is sort of, you know, to be, this... larger-than-life guy that a lot of people know me as, and it sort of brought me from being the, really...
I just can't find the words to explain to you guys how much it means that you watch my Let's Plays of Pokemon Blue. All those kids that kicked my ass in junior high, who's laughing now? Oh, yeah! The original video's not up anymore. These are the fucking messages the dude who put the clips up and the people who are laughing at him got. Let me see what we got here. To Sebmall, I believe you would remember this video you uploaded. If not, it was about a month ago. You'll know it when you see it. But on to the matter at hand. Don't fucking upload shit like this. Anything that shows the personal problems of another person. Surely you've had days where some shit went down with you or your family. How would you feel if everything you ever did, your worst moments in life, were recorded and put up for others to watch? If every one of your failures was considered schadenfreude? I know you blow me off. I can tell you're the scum of the earth. I have to say, don't fuck with my friends. I'm a pacifist, so I would not go out of my way to harm you. But rest assured, having your blood upon my hands would be great. Hey, tough guy, I'm gonna fuck you up. Well, not actually me, I'm a pacifist. But bad things are maybe gonna happen to you because somebody else might do something. But it won't be me. Because I'm too much of a pussy to do anything other than send you a message on YouTube saying, hey, stop it. Just don't. Just don't.
What a piece of shit.
I'm guessing this guy's the one that was uploading the clips of his mom smacking him and the clips of him crying at the speedrunning event. Put both of them up.
No. Fucking, why do people tell me to fucking take
I think this is the video we just watched. Let me see if there's anything new here.
Lot of fucking nerve. Lot of fucking nerve.
Oh, here comes...
Never raise your voice.
Here comes Gobble Gobble.
Yep. Oh, stop it. Stop it.
Hold on.
Stop.
I need to stop this.
He made his fucking mother gobble. I can't believe he did that. Oh, this dude got a lot of messages. Lots of messages. And I think it's actually from UltraJMan. Let's see what he got. Hey, look, Uzanair. Maybe if you watched any of my vast variety of LPs, your opinion would have merit. So maybe you should shut the fuck up, you stupid faggot cunt. In fact, go suck more dicks. Suck Pale's dick. Suck Oz's dick. Suck everyone's dick on SA who's a stupid bitch that can't fucking LP. You're the biggest faggot I've ever seen, and represent all that's wrong with the internet. God damn. I hope you fucking die. I also hope Oz fucking dies. Pale is the only person I find cool in your little clique, because he's actually legit awesome. But fuck the rest of your stupid faggot bitch-ass friends. Better yet, do an LP yourself that isn't complete garbage, and maybe your opinion will have some kind of merit. Until then, continue being the scum of the internet that everyone scrapes off their fucking shoe at the end of the day. Oof. The guy that makes his mother gobble like a turkey and has fucking emotional breakdowns in a room full of autists sure talks a tough fucking game on the internet, doesn't he? Oh, he's a tough boy. We got any, are there any others, or is that all we're going to get? Let me skip ahead a little here. He told him, you better watch out. All right, I let's play Rayman. Big fucking deal over here. Maybe you don't know who I am. I'm top number one big guy on Something Awful's LP sub forum. All right, you better watch your ass. I'm going to get you retsuprayed. Okay? Slow Beef, I know that guy. He's going to retsupray the shit out of you if you laugh at me any more than you've already laughed at me. And my friends are going to send you messages saying they hope bad things happen to you, but they're too much of a pacifist to do it themselves. Oh, shameful. Just shameful. Hardcore parkour, you're right, chat. He's a tough boy. That's a guy you don't want to fuck with. All right, he's going to bring the thunder down right on your goddamn head. Those Let's Players, tough sons of bitches. Is Slow Beef dead? I don't know. I just find it funny a dude that was, you know, one of the people that did all these rat surprises and talked all the shit about what a bad fucking Let's Play is, put up that Let's Play of Dark Souls. Have you ever seen Slow Beef's LP of Dark Souls? It's like the shit he makes fun of, but he's being serious. I don't know if he's alive or dead at the moment, though. I couldn't tell you. I haven't looked at the LP sub forum in like 8 years, so I have no idea who's still among the living there. Let me find Chibi now. Our little boy Chibi Necodemics. I can't even say the fucking name. I'm sure it's based off some weird conglomeration of anime. Little Chinese girl cartoons, and he merged them all together to come out with that clusterfuck of a fucking name. But you can just call him Chibi. He's the guy that that cheated in a speedrun by using tool assisting, or he did some fucked up thing, and people nailed his ass on it. Gave a heartfelt apology and was driven out of the fucking community. But I met him way, way back in the day. He was friends with Big Al 2K6. And he was a weird little fucker. Yeah, wore dog collars, was a heavy emo goth kid, eyeliner and dark makeup, and, you know, it liked just the whole emo scene was very into that. Very, very, very into that. Okay, I've got this queued up. Let's take a look at some Chibi. I don't know if this is a video where his mom gets pissed because they keep sending her pizzas, or if this is the one where he gets busted. We'll find out.
Best. Well, it won't be off until about another 2 hours from now, because I'm in the middle of a speedrun. It's only 1 o'clock.
Excuse me, mother, but I'm in the middle of a speedrun of Paper Mario, and I'm not sure if you're aware of this, but it's kind of a big deal. So why don't you take your whore ass back upstairs, and I'll come slap you on the ass when I want breakfast. All right, big boys are up right now at 1 in the morning, speedrunning video games in your basement. I'm not going to do chores. I'm not going to bathe. I'm going to play video games. Now you just walk over into the corner with a sign that says shut the fuck up, and you wait for me to finish.
And this is the weekend.
I don't care.
Of course you don't. You don't care about anything.
No, I don't care, okay? We talked about this shit, about you being on it all night long.
I'm not being on it all night
long. I don't
care
if it's a weekend or not. It doesn't matter. Every day runs together for you.
No, actually it doesn't.
Adam?
I like how he went silent there. I don't know if you noticed what happened, but this is a nightmare scenario for our little speedrunner. He's known as Chibi Necodemix, but his mother got angry enough at him to use his name. Adam, all the days are running together for you. You need to, you know, wash your balls. It smells terrible down here. I met this man, this Canadian man named Mr. Peterson. I think he can help you. But Chibi is talking all this shit back to her. But the moment she says Adam, suddenly he gets quiet.
It's not happening. Why do you keep insisting on it? I'm so sick of going over and over this shit with you.
So am I.
Then why aren't you listening to me?
Because I have a life to live, and I'm living it.
excuse me, mother. I have a life I'm living in the basement at 1 in the morning speedrunning Mario for 3 people watching me on Twitch. he said that in a serious manner. There was no, he really believes that. Like, I have a life. This is my life. I wish, what would his reaction be if he sat in front of a mirror and said that? He's probably put a shotgun in his mouth.
No, I'm going to unplug it if you get a smart mouth on you. Don't give me that crap.
I'm not giving you any crap at all.
Yeah, you are. I told you, this isn't happening all night long.
It's not all night long.
What?
It's not all night long. It's not even close.
3 o'clock in the morning?
Yeah, I don't see.
Dad made me promise, told me to make sure this wasn't happening all hours of the night.
Yeah,
it is.
No, it's not.
Yeah, it is. 3 o'clock in the morning is all hours of the night.
Okay.
Adam. Why do you have to put me in these situations and these predicaments?
You're the one putting me in the predicament.
Yeah, I am, and I'm not unplugged.
I believe this is your fault, Mother. If you just let me stay up 24 hours a day playing my Paper Mario game, we wouldn't have any predicaments. I like the title, too. 25-year-old Chibi interrupted during a speedrun by his mother. In his basement at his mother's house, speedrunning on Twitch for 3 people at 2 in the morning. And he's arguing with his mother that he does, in fact, have a life, as she chastises him. How embarrassing. How embarrassing to have your mother show up behind you on a live stream and tell you to go to bed. You need to get your big boy sleep, okay? Otherwise, you're going to be cranky in the morning, and I don't want to deal with that on the car ride to the therapist.
In about 2 seconds.
Oh, fuck, I called that. It was a joke, but I called that. When I said she was going to be cranky on the way to the therapist. And she literally follows that up with, your counselor told me.
Just go ahead and do it. I threaten it. You don't think that I'm really going to do it, and I will. You just totally ignore me. No, just in no regard. I told you I want your sheets changed today.
They weren't dirty.
Now they're getting yellow. You got...
Oh, how devastating is this? She's on... You need to wash your bed. It's piss stained. You filthy fucking animal. They're yellow. Your sheets are yellow. You don't smoke. There's only one way they're going to get yellow. You're urinating in the bed. You're sleeping in your piss. You need to wash your sheets. What is the matter with you?
Food and your sheets. I'm telling you, Adam, I'm gonna plug this. I swear I am. I'm gonna plug the whole back of it. And the whole thing will be out. Compromise. No 2 hours.
See, that's where she lost already. You're going to notice as we watch clips like this, because we're going to watch a few of them, that every one of these is the mother interrupting the son. And every one of them involves the word compromise. If you're a fucking parent and you need to compromise with your 25-year-old son that hasn't left the fucking house yet, and he pisses in his bed and doesn't bathe, you've lost the battle. Here's what you should do instead. Go find the electrical box and turn it off. Because he's too fucking dumb to know how to turn that back on. Take a couple plugs out. He's not going to know what to do. It's all fucking, it's like alien to him. All right, unless it has a controller attached, he's lost. You've won the battle. There's no need to compromise. Just cut the fucking electricity off at the source.
Right now, compromiser, I'm plugging it.
2 hours is all I can give you.
3 o'clock in the morning is not acceptable. That's too late. You're down here too long doing this crap.
I like how he keeps looking at the chat. That's where he's looking off to the left. He's reading his chat as they're saying, dude, this is humiliating. But he won't look at his mother. He'll look at what people on the other side of the world have to say, but not the woman standing directly behind him in the same room has to say. That's if you want to talk about socialization problems. He'd rather read his Twitch chat than look in his mother's eyes at all for a second.
I mean it. I'm unplugging it. Give me a compromise.
That's the best I can compromise. Yes, it is. To guarantee that once the speedrun is over, I'm done streaming.
And what's gonna stop you from doing it tomorrow night, or the next night, or the next night?
Because I have work on Sunday, number one.
Okay.
It's the only day of the week that I work, is that one Sunday. For 3 hours down at the local corner store where they have me clean the parking lot up. It's arduous. And I need the other 6 days of the week to play Paper Mario.
What time?
3 to 10.
Oh, then that's going to stop you. If you have work at 3 o'clock, that's going to stop you from being on it all night, tomorrow night?
Yeah, it will.
Adam, this isn't happening every night. I'm getting really tired of this. You promised me you were gonna that things were gonna be different around here.
You're the one making a big deal out of 3 a.m.
No, you promised things would be different, Adam.
Can you imagine his mother's life? Like, she has to get up. It's 3 in the morning. He's been up all night playing this shit. She has to get up to go to work to keep the electricity on and to keep the mortgage paid and to keep food in the pantry. And every time she starts to slowly drift off to sleep, really loudly from the floorboards, because he's in the basement, she hears, "Ding, ding, wahoo, yippee!" Could you, it'd be like Chinese water torture. How many bing, bing, wahoos could you stand listening to before you took a baseball bat into your son's room?
Things are not different. For a couple of days, you know, then they get better, and then all of a sudden it goes back to the same old shit again.
This isn't even anywhere close to the same old shit.
At 2 o'clock, I'm unplugging this.
I'm gonna go as fast as I can, but I can't make any guarantees.
Not happening tomorrow.
Won't happen tomorrow night, no.
Oh, he's so... just, I want to reach to the screen and just slap him. Just smack him across the face. You're working one day a week on a Sunday. Your poor mother. Your poor fucking mother. Can't get to sleep because she keeps hearing fucking Mario screaming out bing bing wahoo yippee as you bounce around speedrunning this fucking game night after night after night. She probably has nightmares about it. She probably wakes up in a cold sweat thinking Italian plumbers have broken into her fucking house.
Technically, I already have a time limit on this crap.
Oh, and you can tell this motherfucker's deep into it, because he's playing the Japanese version of the game. So he's so desperate to cut his speedrunning time down by, like, half a fucking second after his 8-hour play session, that he's playing the fucking Japanese version for those quicker load times. So she's definitely hearing this shit all night long, every night, all day long, every day. I think he actually stunned her to silence. Like, her brain doesn't work this early in the morning. And she's just like, I don't fucking... Why didn't I have that abortion? Why didn't I let Harold... I'm guessing that's her husband's name. Why didn't I let Harold just take the coat hanger and shove it directly into me? What the fuck was I thinking? Why did I want to have children?
I already pay for the internet, and yeah, I could offer to pay the electricity bill. Oh boy, here she comes again.
Tomorrow, you're cleaning this room, you're cleaning those sheets, and you're taking care of the shit on the table. Got it? Or you're not touching it and screaming until it's all done.
You know, I know there's an... Let me see if I can find this here. Give me one moment. I know there's a video out there of his mother yelling at him because people started delivering pizzas to him while every time he would stream, they'd start ordering pizzas for him. And she could not stand it. Let me see if I can find it. Oh, yeah, here we go.
First one that I actually...
Okay, all right, I found it. I found it. Yeah, because he became a popular target to fuck with for a while. So they'd wait for him to stream, and then they'd just start doing all sorts of shit to him, just to try to get a reaction. And his mother was always the one that had to deal with it. So I believe this is from when they were sending him pizzas nonstop, and his mother was not fucking thrilled about it. let's give it a watch.
First one there, actually, but you need to, like... Hold on, let me just do this one. You need to, like, not do super backspin.
Give me just a second. What?
You need to get off of it. Two people now showed up. Passport pizza and Fred's. You need to shut this down. They see that you're on there. These kids see that you're on there.
Adam, the internet keeps sending us pizzas. You need to shut it down, Adam. Mario Golf is not worth this harassment. I've had 3 pepperoni sent to me, Adam.
Pulling the same shit again.
Okay, so...
Is there any way you can contact Facebook and tell them to block this bullshit?
No, there isn't.
Well, there's gotta be. There's gotta be a way to get on, to call Google, Facebook, something, email them, whatever, and tell them that they put your...
I want you get on the phone right now, mister, and you call up Facebook and you say, stop sending us pizzas. You get a hold of that Mark Zuckerstern, or whatever his name is, and you tell him enough.
your name and phone number on there, and you need somehow to block it. We're gonna lose our phone number because of this. Because I asked them, I said, what number did they call from? And they said they called from this number. You need to get off for the night. Thank God Dad isn't here. Because now I hear the phone beeping up there like someone's been calling in here too. So I can just hardly wait. He was pissed. The guy from Passport was really pissed.
I also like how the mom, she's, I don't blame her because she has no idea, but she's basically telling the people that are fucking with them that the businesses they're calling are getting even more angry. So every time they continue to do it, it's going to lead to a bigger and bigger escalation of an argument on the doorstep. Oh, those pizza guys were there. They're real mad. Those pizza guys were real upset at them. The first thing they're going to do is order like 20 more pizzas.
That policeman back again, that phone number on that card he gave you, and tell him that they're doing it again to you.
Oh, let me check one thing here. Okay, volume's coming in fine. Sometimes the clips can sound a little low, but she's we gotta call the police again. Those fucking pizza guys from Facebook keep showing up. He goes right back to it. He doesn't even care.
I gotta go.
Alrighty, dude.
Because people are people just.
Yeah, I understand.
As soon as I went live, I guess they started ordering pizzas, and like two or three pizza places have now tried delivering pizzas to us.
Dude, that sucks.
So I got, it got a little bit worse than it did before.
Oh shit, dude. That's pretty serious. We'll talk about it like after.
Yeah.
What you gotta do, dude, I understand.
Oh bro, that's pretty serious. Those Facebook pizza guys don't fuck around. You better call the sheriff and the state police. Those Facebook pizza guys, they mean fucking business. It's real serious, Adam. I'm afraid for your life.
We'll try this again like another time.
Yeah.
Is Metokur still here?
I don't know.
But damn, that really, really sucks.
Oh.
Alright, just gotta do, dude.
Sorry, guys.
We can just end the race, we don't have to, like, complete it.
Yeah.
It's probably been a while since I've been doing this, too, so I might as well take a break from it, too.
Mm-hmm.
Way too long. Alright, where's our Sorrel? I'll just quit the race, then.
Poor little Chibi. Let me, I think there might be one more clip of this happening to him. Let me see if I can find it. I'll take a look, chat, and see if I can find some more Chibi gets pizzas delivered. Oh, do you want to, shit, do you want to watch, some guy calls Chibi's mom? Do you want to watch the classic video clip of a guy, ratting Chibi out to his mother and informing her of Chibi's dick pics that were sent to minors on the internet? You tell me. Do we want to listen to the call of somebody calling his mother up to say that your son is sending pornography to children on the internet? Or is that not something you're interested in? Oh, I'm seeing a lot of yeses pop up. Okay.
Hello?
Let me get this ready. I'll play this in 1 second. A couple people are asking, how do they know his address and who is this exactly? Best way I can sum it up, it's a really awkward, socially awkward dude, right? He gets into the speedrunning and Let's Play community. He starts to do moderately okay, and he gets a bit of a following going. But he's known for all his drama bullshit, right? And he eventually gets busted for cheating at speedrunning. Like, blatantly cheating at speedrunning. So badly so that people were able to catch him instantly. So he gets kind of driven out of the community. And the entire time this is going on, he's always going on Twitter and saying, I'm going to kill myself, my life is over, I don't want to live anymore. Everything is so sad, woe is me. And then people start finding him doing this really weird, creepy shit. And then he gets doxxed, and then they proceed to fuck with him every time he tries to speedrun something and start calling his mother. So that's the really quick and dirty version of who this guy is. I'll put the video up. I don't know if I've actually watched this one before. Maybe it's a bust. Maybe it's good. Everything working. Yep. This is some guy calls Chibi's mom. Let's find it. Let's go. Let's fucking go.
Hello.
Yeah, hi. Are you Adam's mom?
Yes, I am.
Yes, ma'am. I had some information I wanted to share you that your son has posted pictures of his penis online and he admitted to sending them to a 17-year-old girl.
What?
Yeah.
What? My baby did what? Oh, I could. She's gonna go Kyle's mom on his ass. I just wanted to inform you that your 26-year-old son is sending his penis to children on the internet. Jimmy!
Yes, your son Adam sent pictures of his penis to an underage girl, and he posted the pictures of his penis online.
Who am I talking to?
This is Jonathan.
She goes to get him. Oh, Adam, you get up here right now. Are you sending pictures of your little willy whacker to girls on the internet? I hope he asks for the mother's email so he can send her a picture of the dick and then she asks to compare it. Now, Adam, you listen here. I need to make sure. Are you really sending your tallywhacker to those kids? I need you to take your pants off, mister. And get a hard-on for Mommy, because she needs to compare it forensically to these photos that Jonathan sent me. We need to get to the bottom of this. Show Mommy your willy, Adam.
No, I did not. Well, somebody's saying you did. What's going on here?
I don't know, Mother.
I don't know, Mother. I don't remember sending my penis to children on the internet, Mom! Speedrunning Paper Mario, come on!
You didn't do it? No, I did not.
Well,
I wasn't
saying
that you did.
Hello?
Don't
talk to me. I gotta talk to you. Did you hear?
No.
Yeah, hey ma'am, it sounded like we got disconnected.
Yeah, I'm trying to figure out what's happening here. I'm really upset about what's happening here.
Ma'am, if you provide me with your email address, I'll be happy to send the...
Oh, he did! I don't... He did! The dude emailed pictures of his dick to his own mother! Oh, that is savage as fuck. Adam, how are you going to deny this when she looks at the dingleberries and that she knows they're yours? Those are my baby's twigs and berries. Mama knows. Give me your email. I want to send you pics of your kid's cock.
Pictures to you. If you
who
want.
Who am I talking to, though?
This is Jonathan.
Okay, and I just trying to figure this out.
Well, the girl sent the pictures to me, and she said that Adam sent them to her.
Adam, some girl is 17 years old. Did you know that? There's not a 17-year-old girl. Do you know what this girl's name is?
Her name is Amy, but I don't know if he knew her by that name. He probably knew her. By her online name, and I'm not really sure what that is. But if you have an email address, I could send some stuff to you if you like.
Yeah, do that, please.
Okay.
I can't believe we're actually listening to this happen. Think about this for a moment. This dude sending his dick pics to chicks on the internet, and this guy calls his mother up, gets her email address, and then forwards those penis pictures to Mommy. Adam's going to be going through his own version of Penis Inspection Day instead of live streaming for his audience on Twitch. That is fucking masterful.
Okay, what is your email?
Hang on one second here. Jimmy, I just want you to know something. He's got some
issues. He has Asperger's, autism.
I just want you to know that my baby boy's got the autism, so him sending pictures of his willy to people, that's pretty much normal for us. We can't keep his penis in his pants, really. We're not allowed in public parks anymore, because he just can't help himself. Sometimes when we walk by sandboxes, he'll just start yelling at children and waving it in the air like it's a little flag. It's a little pole with a flag on the end of it. We don't know what to do, that's why we bought the taser.
Sometimes he doesn't think clearly, and he makes stupid choices and stupid decisions.
Yes, ma'am.
So, please, I beg of you, don't, you know, go any further with this, and it will never, ever, ever happen again.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. I understand.
You know?
Yes.
He's a good kid. I'm trying to right now, even trying to get him on Social Security because he's got a...
I understand.
And I know he could be in big trouble for doing this, and I will have a long talk with him, and I'm sick about this.
Yes.
This poor mom. What a nightmare it must be to have this fucking sped as her kid. Can you imagine getting calls from the internet about him sending his cock pictures to people? Just pizzas getting delivered, bing, bing, wahoo at 3 in the morning. Oh, this poor woman. She's not going to make it to 50. Like, there's no way. She's going to get an exit bag and get the fuck out of there.
Ma'am, I understand.
Please promise me that you won't go any further with this, because I promise you this will never, ever happen again.
Yes, ma'am. I won't. Don't worry.
And please ask her, and I promise you that she will never hear from him again either.
Yes, ma'am. Don't worry.
And this won't go any
I understand
further.
Your predicament.
Okay.
Don't worry. Yes, ma'am. I'm happy to help.
I'm happy to help. Don't worry. I won't tell anybody. I'll just upload it as a video on YouTube. Don't worry about it.
Thank okay. you so,
yes,
so
ma'am.
Much.
I'll email you right now, okay?
Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
Bye-bye.
Bye. And now he's online. I can read it right now. He just said at 4:43 p.m. We exchanged pictures like that. She sent me pictures, too. And it's almost like he's bragging about getting pictures from this underage girl. It's very disturbing, to say the least.
Adam, he's not. You said he's online right now.
I can read what he said. Yeah, and it was 5 minutes ago. He posted
because
it five minutes
he's
ago.
He's been up here talking to Social Security.
Well, he posted these.
I'm the one that texted you guys back.
Ma'am, he can post from his phone as well. He can post from his phone as well. He can post messages
did
from
you,
his
did
phone.
You put something on there about how she sent stuff back to you too. Did you?
No.
I can read it. I can read it right now. I can send you screenshots if you'd like
Hold
to.
On.
Can you imagine the balls on this chibi guy? Adam is sitting in the living room as his mother is talking to a dude on the phone about his dick pics. And he, instead of trying to play it cool or to act like this isn't real or to just hang his head down and ride it out, he jumps onto fucking Skype or social media or whatever the fuck this is from and starts talking about it from his fucking phone.
Okay, tell me.
We exchanged.
Tell me what you were
going to
say.
Want me to say it? We exchanged pictures like that. We exchanged pictures like that. She sent me pictures too, is what he said. He said, I was 18, she was 17.
Did you say that?
Yeah, I did. Oh, he admitted it! He's not even good at lying! That wasn't even 30 seconds! Adam, are you posting up here? No, mother. Adam, did you say that? Yeah, I did. Oh, what a fucking tard.
Well, because I just...
I don't know. Chibi's kind of scared. Chibi's kind of scary to her, because...
I would be more than happy to talk to her. He has a girlfriend right now that he really cares about a lot. And,
She said that he had some really violent, like, I don't know, fetishes and stuff. He wanted to... have sex with men and make her watch and things like that were just very disturbing.
That's what he said to her?
Oh, no, 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 no. Adam, what are you doing? Oh, Adam, mommy's hearing about all your dirty thoughts. Oh, he wanted to fuck men and make her watch it. Miss Chibi, Chibi's mom, your baby boy wanted to get pegged in his ass while she watched it happen.
Yes, ma'am.
What, wait, that, wait, what, that? back then?
Yeah, he wanted to have sex with a man and make her watch, and that really frightened her.
But you...
She is fucking speechless. Could you imagine getting this phone call as a parent? She doesn't know what to say! This dude just told her son wants to get fucked in his ass while a kid watches it happen. And she doesn't know what to say.
Like I said, if there's anything that I can do, if I can talk to this girl, I would be more than happy to talk to her. He will not, you know... He has not done anything like that. I mean, back then, I know he dated someone. We said, Adam, though he was 18... He had the mentality of a 13-year-old.
Yeah, I understand.
You know what I mean?
I understand, yes, ma'am. I'm sorry to trouble you with this. I didn't mean to, you know, yeah.
Yeah, he had some weird fetishes back then. He's really a nice guy. I don't know.
It sounds to me like the mom's trying to hook her son up. Like, hey, dude on the phone, Jonathan. Listen, you know, my baby boy, he's a pretty good-looking kid. I mean, he's 20, you know, 25. I shouldn't call him a kid, but he's kind of retarded, so we'll just act like he's a kid. But he's a good-looking guy. You free Saturday night? Let's make that fetish, that fantasy happen. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know this girl. Why don't you fuck my baby boy in his bottom? And she can watch it. We'll stream it on Twitch. It'll be a great show.
He's trying to do something on the internet and working for a company. Got all kinds of people calling him and telling him that they want to try to have him commit suicide. They don't need any autistic kids online, and they don't need any autistic gamers.
Oh, that's really sad.
On there, and I know he used to wear this stupid collar around his dumb neck.
Oh, she knows about it. Yeah, that's the dog collar I was talking about. She calls it a stupid collar. I'll try to dig up pictures. There's some pictures I don't think are publicly out there of what he used to look like and the retarded shit he used to wear. Let me try to give you a basic idea of what these pictures look like. I want you to imagine him with his hair dyed dark, like dark black, and a studded dog collar around his neck with mascara and painted fingernails. And then he's got really long, like baggy pants, and he's got a little fake tail that's glued onto the back of his jeans and dog ears. Because he's a furry, too, by the way. Did I mention that? So he's got the dog collar on, the furry ears, the tail, and he's wearing heavy makeup.
Yeah. Why did he wear the collar? I was very confused. Yeah.
Huh?
Why did he wear that collar? I was confused by it.
Anymore.
Oh, okay.
Because it was a video game character that used to dress with this long collar.
No, that's not why. That Chibi's mom, he lied to you. Your son was a deviant. He just was afraid to tell mommy that he was into some kinky shit.
Oh, wear this thing around his neck or whatever.
Oh, okay.
He just had a lot of screwy ideas.
Okay, gotcha.
If he took the collar off, he would die.
He had some crazy ideas, like if he took the collar off, he would die. Mommy, I can't take the dog collar off. I'll die if I do that. Yeah, that's a sane thing to say to your parents at the dinner table.
Crazy, crazy idea.
He was a big guy, is what you're saying. I understand.
What's that?
He was a big guy.
No, he just had a lot of crazy ideas that were just a little off the wall. Hello?
Yeah.
Just a little off the wall. They're just, it's a little weird. You know, wants to have an underage girl watch him get fucked in the ass by a stranger. Won't take his dog collar off. Because he'll die if he does that. You know, just minor weird things. Please don't say anything about my autistic crazy son. I don't want my baby boy going to big boy prison. I don't think he's going to last. I'll be honest with you. I don't think our little Chibi's going to last. Oh, the autism. Chat, the fucking autism of it. Oh, boy. Yeah, I haven't watched Chibi. I have not heard that call before, but that's some pretty good shit, and that's been up there for only a year. So somebody re-uploaded that. That's obviously a video that was up there a long time ago. Just got put up again recently. So well done, NTR is for Thinker. Thank you for sharing that with the internet. Fantastic stuff. Let me see if I can find, since we're on the subject of mothers yelling at their children. I don't know what I can't remember his fucking name. Let's see if I can find this shit. Oh my god. Roblox kid mom yelling, maybe. Oh, maybe you can help me out, chat. It's the kid that said his mother caught him looking at porn while he was live streaming, and he told her he got hacked and the virus scared him so much his pants fell off. Does anybody remember what that kid's name was? It happened in Roblox. I'll wait for chat to catch up. Somebody has to remember that fucking kid's name, because I know that clip is out there somewhere. Awesomenator, thank you. That's close enough. Oh, did they take them all? No, there's no way they took them down. Here we go.
I'm listening.
Okay. Let me get the setup for this going. Yeah, people have heard this before, obviously, because people can remember the name. But it's a collection of clips. We'll watch some of it, see if you guys like it. Set the backstory for you. Want you to imagine a kid that's like probably 12 or 13 years old. I cannot tell you for the life of me why this is recorded. Okay, what you need to understand is this little deviant is he's obviously watching pornography while he's either live streaming or in a call with people. I don't know what it is, but for whatever reason, mommy finds it. She walks into the room while he's beating off, and then he has to think of an excuse. And while this is happening, he forgets that it's a hot mic. He doesn't understand that he left his mic on. So his friends record the entire thing and then upload it on the internet for everybody to have a laugh at. And his name is Awesomenator. So let me throw that one up. Let's, what do you say, chat? You want to give it a listen? Let's give it a listen.
Listen. It's a virus.
Listen, Harris, and I'm sorry, but I have to have your dad talk to you about this, because mom's not very good about
it. No, mom,
Listen. Mom,
I was searching around.
Why are you playing with yourself?
I was searching around the internet.
Oh my gosh. Okay. Listen,
no, I was searching around the internet, and all of a sudden, I was downloading this thing, and I got a computer virus.
I want to see it. Show me what you were downloading.
I randomly...
Oh, she has, like, the most stereotypical mom voice. I want you to show me what you're downloading. Why are you touching your willy? Oh, shit. No kid... No boy wants to have a talk about what he's jacking off to with his mother. But she has literally caught him with his pants down. And she's demanding to see what he was watching. That is nightmare material. That's the kind of shit that wakes up a teenage boy in the middle of the night with, like, night sweats. Like, that is the worst case scenario of something that could happen. And it is happening to him while it's being fucking rebroadcast to people.
I got scared because I deleted the virus and I...
No, you're embarrassed.
No, Mom,
Nathan,
for real!
Listen to me, you don't play with yourself.
I didn't!
Alright, I have to go to the bathroom.
Oh my god. You don't get it, do you, Mom? Mom, you don't get it at all!
Don't play with your
I did!
She's still scolding him while she's taking a shit in the toilet! You don't play with your ding dong. Oh, this poor fucking kid. Oh, he is scarred. You're right, Chet. He is fucking scarred for life. There's no coming back from this.
Get it! My pants slipped off!
Why were your pants
there?
No, they did not just slip off.
Yeah, they did! Oh my god, Mom. I had a computer virus, and I got scared that I had the virus. And when I was getting out of my chair, my pants were slipping, and I was pulling them up and getting back on the chair.
Nathan, you don't look at stuff like that.
Mom, it was a virus!
Nathan,
virus, Mom!
Oh, if it was a virus, then why were your pants off?
I got scared, and my pants slipped down a little, and I was pulling them up! Mom! I'm telling the truth!
I think we've all been there. I know sometimes when I notice a virus alert on my computer, my clothing spontaneously comes off. I can't tell you how many times Kapersky has pinged me and said, we've got a problem here, champ. You've got a computer virus. And my pants just, they just come right off. So do my boxers. And then for some reason I get an erection. I don't know what it is. Maybe it's some subliminal messaging in the antiviral program. But I think we've all been there.
Yes, and then I was pulling them up because I got scared of the virus. Oh my God, Mom, for real.
You can hear the pure fucking terror in his voice. Like, this is a sort of shit that puts somebody in therapy 20 years later. Like, he wants to be anywhere but here. To have any other conversation but this one. But his mother won't fucking let it go. Like, she keeps it going. This call goes for like 10 minutes. And this poor kid is on the verge of a nervous fucking breakdown.
Spy on me or something with my camera. So then I was getting off my chair so it wouldn't see me. And
listen, you're not in trouble, okay?
I'm serious, Mom! I'm telling the truth!
Okay,
I'm telling the truth!
I know you're
embarrassed. Oh my.
Holy shit, lady, just let him have it. Just fucking lie. Just be like, okay, it was a virus. And then you can have Dad talk to him later. I don't know why she won't let it go. You can hear. You can feel the fear dripping off of him. Like, you can just visualize it. But she won't let the point rest. She just won't let him get away with it. You're not in trouble. But I know you were touching yourself. And I just want you to know, every time you masturbate, your dead grandpa and grandma are watching you. Their ghosts are in the room, and they watch you abuse yourself. Don't be mad, you're not in trouble. But every dead relative you have is watching you touch yourself. I just want you to know that.
Oh my God, Mom, I'm telling the truth! I'm telling the truth!
I'm not mad at you.
I'm telling the truth! And you're annoying.
Okay, they cut that audio down. Somebody asked, is it 20 minutes of that call? No, it's not. Because apparently this kid and his mother fight all the time. So this is like a compilation of him and his mom having arguments. And I think after that, getting caught jacking off by his mother, like, that was the line in the sand for him. Like, after that day, he decided, gloves are off now, Mom. Like, when you come for me next time, I'm throwing punches back at you.
Talking to me like that because I'm telling Dad. I'm going to talk to Dad about it.
Yeah, is Dad your father?
No, he's your father, and he's not going to be too happy.
Then why do you act like he's yours?
Oh, blown the fuck up, bitch. Come on. Gamers rise up. Can I get an RRU in the fucking chat? He blew her out of the fucking water. Is he your dad? I didn't think so. Shut the fuck up.
Nathan. Smarten up and go to bed. You have to get up.
I already am smart. I'm going to fifth grade.
No, you're not. Because you know what? You don't listen
to me. Oh, yeah, I am. You're not.
No, you're not smartening up because you don't listen to your mother.
Who are you, Mrs. Government?
Let's go, please.
Are you the fucking government, bitch? I didn't think so. I don't see a badge on you, lady. Get the fuck out of my room.
Nathan, I said to shut it off. Why don't you listen to me?
Why do you act like Mrs. President?
I said to get off! I'm getting so sick of this every night!
Well, get on my face and I'll shut it off. Gee!
Well, geez, I say it nicely. Nathan, please. How many times have I called to you?
How's
every
that,
single night.
How's that nicely, you pro?
I don't know if you caught that, Chad. He called her a prick, and then she beat his ass. Let's listen to that one again.
I said to get off! I'm getting so sick of this every night!
Well, get on my face and I'll shut it off. Gee!
Well, geez, I say it nicely. Nathan, please. How many times have I called to you?
How's
every
that,
single night.
How's that nicely, you prick?
I'm so sick of this crap with you! I want you out!
Uh-huh. Now I'm not shutting it off. Cause
yeah, you will!
Fine, God!
Is this what you want? Is this how I have to respond to you?
I don't
Nathan,
know.
I talk to you and I...
Call Mr. Child's support right now. I'm done.
You want to hit me, bitch? I'm calling the authorities. I'm going to get child... I think he said child support. I'm going to get child support up in this house. Oh, you're in trouble, lady? You ain't the government, bitch. I'm going to introduce you to the government. They're going to put cuffs on your ass.
Call child support. I didn't even hurt you. You hurt me every time you don't listen to me. Do you understand me?
Child support phone number.
Nathan, don't you dare.
I will.
You will never have a mother again.
That's your fault.
Oh, he's lighting this bitch on fire. There's no mercy now. You couldn't let him just have it, could you? You just had to keep pressing him on jacking off. Well, now he's going to war, lady. He's calling child support. And those motherfuckers, they went to justice school. Your ass is grass.
You don't do that to me.
Hit your son with a complete douchebag. Watch what
you
happens.
You know what, Nathan? Start listening. Okay? That's being a douchebag.
What's the only solution, hitting?
No, it's not.
Then don't do it!
But you know what, Nathan? Start listening. And maybe Mom won't have to respond like that.
Well, you know what? You're,
now I see
you're
why
a bad mother. You're a bad mother.
Oh, put this bitch in a casket. This motherfucker buried her. Oh, is violence the answer, mother? No, it's not. Well, then maybe you should stop hitting me. Oh, he's just tearing her apart today.
No, I'm not.
Yeah, you are.
Well, you're a bad son because you don't listen.
Go ahead. Tell me what you want to say. It's not going to offend me because you're...
It's not going to affect me either because I'm sick of this.
I'm sick of
listen
you.
To me.
Get out of my face.
Go to bed. Now I know why your father actually...
Well, you know what? If you're going to be a complete douche...
Okay, I think we need to re-listen to that line, because I'm almost certain she said, now I know why your father used to hit. Listen really carefully to what she said. It's either why your father acts like this, or why your father used to hit.
Listen to me!
Get out of my face!
Go to bed. Now I know why your father actually...
Well, you know what? If you're going to be a complete douche like that, then I won't shut it down.
Talk to me like that. I gave you life. And you treat
me
like crap.
The only thing you're trying to specifically give me right now is a bunch of bruises because you don't know how to parent properly.
No,
crap.
That's not...
Oh, you're abusive. I'm calling child support. Oh, he's just no prisoners today. Your little baby boy had enough of your shit, lady. Oh, you just couldn't let him jack off in peace. You just had to keep pushing him. Pushing him and pushing him. Well, now it's time to throw down. He took your best hits, and he's coming back for more.
That's true. It is true! Nathan, I asked you, please go to bed. You have to get up in the morning.
Yes, hitting me in the head a million times,
yeah,
asking.
Okay.
Get the heck out of my room.
You know what, Nathan? I didn't hit you when I asked you. I said it, Nathan. I called to you since 10:30. Actually, 20 after.
Yeah, and you said I can stay on.
No, I said I want you off by 10.
You know, you should really keep your word because you said I could stay on for a little bit longer. And you still keep causing bullcrap.
Nathan, I said at 10 o'clock, please get off so you can go to bed and watch a show.
And then you said I can stay up longer. So bullcrap.
No, I didn't.
Bullcrap.
You know what? Stop talking to me like that. Your friends act better than you.
Cool. I don't care.
Go to bed now. You better listen.
No, because you kept hitting me.
Nathan?
You
hit again?
No.
Because then go to bed.
God, you're annoying.
Stop acting like such a spurg, Mom. Get the fuck out of my room. What, are you going to hit me, little lady? Doesn't hurt. I'm calling child support on your ass.
Is that how I have to respond to you? I don't like that.
I don't like you either. You're a bad mother! You're a bad mother! You're a bad mother! You're a bad mother!
He's straight up bullying her now. He's reached the point where he's taunting her ass. He talks shit to her face and now he's literally taunting her. He's fucking with her for laughs at this point.
Hey everyone! My mom thinks hitting is the only solution!
Lyle, stop! Come on!
That's enough!
Well, it's true.
Go to bed! You don't holler like that!
Funny thing is, my friends agree with me 100%.
What, Nathan? I'm so tired of the way you treat me.
Cool, I'm tired of you too.
How many different ways can I say this, bitch? I don't give a fuck. Do you need me to draw you a picture? Let me draw it with both my middle fingers. You getting the idea now, lady? No fucks are given in the Zoomer Zone. You need to get the fuck out of here. All right, go back to the old age home. Daddy doesn't love you, neither does his son.
Nice job physically hitting your son, too.
Got the all-hard for you.
And you know what? You wanted to be treated like that? Your fault. Funny thing is that you're the one hitting me in the first place. What? Okay, I don't care. You hit your son. Well, you know what? You're gonna be treated the same way if you're gonna be the douchebag who hits their son all the time. Hi, I'm... My only solution to fix my son is hitting.
I like how he's literally turned the tables on her. Like, she caught him jacking off and wouldn't let it go. So now he's got her by the metaphorical balls. And he's not going to let that shit go. Oh, you hit me, lady. And I'm going to tell you about it every single fucking day of your life. Remember when you couldn't walk away and just say, yeah, sure, it was a virus? It's fucking payback time.
And plus, if you broke these headphones in the process of hitting me, then guess what? Then I would be forcing you to get new ones. So you're lucky these didn't break because of you. I'm not going to bed at 10:30 because I'm getting older, Mom. I should be going to bed later than 10:30.
But guess what? It's actually 11.
You think it's such a big deal about me not going to bed at stupid 10:30? It's such a big deal that you hit your own son? You shouldn't even be hitting your son in the first place. Terrible mother you are.
I don't mean to do that, but next time...
If you don't mean to do it, then don't do it at all.
He's just feeding her to the dogs. I don't know. Let's take a pause at this for a second. We're about halfway through the incredible conversations of Awesomenator and his mother. What do you think, chat? You think this kid is just, I see a bright future ahead of him. His mother beats him, and then he tells her ass, you know those headphones you bought me that you broke when you smacked me? I'm gonna make your ass buy me another pair. You don't know who you're fucking with here. I am Awesomenator. You stepped to the wrong motherfucker today. She's weak, it's pathetic, yes she is. Yeah, it's halfway, there are other conversations. I hope this one, I heard audio once of this kid, where he started talking about why his father left her, and it absolutely fucking destroys her. Like, he brings up the reason why dad left mom, and like, you could just hear her soul break in half. Like, no fucking prisoners. Like, ever since that jack-off thing, this kid's been out for fucking blood with his mother. And he's gonna get it one way or another.
Then listen to me. St- Stop making
Well, you
me
know
tell
what?
You
even if I didn't listen, even if I didn't listen, you shouldn't be the douchebag who hits the
Stop
wrong son.
Stop telling me that.
Well, yeah. Well,
you're the douchebag son that can't go to bed when
well,
he's
you know
told.
What? If you're gonna have a problem with being called those names, then you're gonna have.
Then I'm gonna start calling.
Then that's
you
your
that.
Problem because you're the person that even brought it up.
Well, then I'm gonna start calling you that because you call me that.
And that makes
I
you,
guess you like that.
And that makes you even more of one.
Well, that makes you more of one, too. It goes both ways.
Oh, you can hear the passive-aggressiveness dripping. The mother is legitimately mad at this point. But it's devolved into a no-you argument. That's you ever hear an argument, you ever read an argument on the internet, on social media, where people basically are essentially screaming no-you at each other? That's what you're listening to between a mother and her son, in real time, in audio form. I know you are, but what am I? That's what she's been reduced to.
Ha ha, you're...
Go to bed.
You're a douchebag.
Nathan?
Yeah, you said you're gonna call me one. Call me one. I'm not gonna be
Go
offended.
To bed. I'm done.
No, I'm not offended. I'm not offended.
Well, I'm not offended by you. Go to bed. I've had it.
Yeah, sure you're not. If you're not offended, then why are you crying like a little baby?
I'm not even crying. Go to bed.
You were. You're like, why don't you respect
Nathan?
Me?
He's full on shit talking her. Oh, come on, what's the matter, little girl? You gonna cry for me? You gonna cry for me, douchebag? Oh, let me lick your tears up. I want to feed off your fucking suffering, cunt.
That's not showing me any respect.
Well, you know what? Well, you know what? You don't need respect if you're gonna be hitting your son, physically hitting your son, and claiming you're gonna call them names like that.
I don't do that.
So basically, you don't even deserve the stuff that you want.
Nathan, what is your problem?
What is your problem?
If you're pissed because Dad and I aren't together, you're not going to take it out on me. I don't care anymore. Is that your problem?
No. The problem is that you're a bad parent.
No, I'm not, Nathan.
Oh, really? What the heck was that crap?
I am tired of you. This is my home.
What was that
you're
crap
raise
the
your
past
voice
20
today.
Minutes ago?
You don't
ago.
Raise your voice to me. Ever. You're going to start showing respect
well,
to me.
Well, this is raising their voice, too.
Go to bed now. I asked you too many times. I'm going
well,
to bed way too
to
late.
Tell you something.
I have to go
you
up in 5 hours. So don't you. Go
yeah.
to bed.
Okay. So first of all, if you actually want me to go to bed, then why do you keep bringing up a bunch of bullcrap?
Go to bed, please.
I can't if you're bringing up bullcrap. You should realize that by now.
I don't see you going.
Yeah, and I don't see you leaving, so I actually can do that specific task!
Stop yelling. Do you understand me?
I'm not yelling. You're the one being a
you're
mental
yelling.
Retard.
Oh, God.
I think he's... What's the term? Gaslighting? I think he's trying to drive her insane. I'm not the one yelling, bitch. You're the one yelling. Stop being hysterical. Stop crying, okay? Man the fuck up. This is why Dad left. Get your shit together, lady. Stop hitting me. What's the matter with you? You're so crazy. Oh, you're so fucking crazy. This is why Dad left. Get out of my room. He's trying to drive her to suicide.
Yeah, and one of these days, you're not going to have me. So same thing goes with you. You want me to tell you something, Mom? The funny thing is that you already lost yours. I don't even care if you wake me up early.
Do you want to get whacked again? Because that is how I have to respond to you. Is that what you want? For me to hit you?
I don't know. Do you want me to call child support?
Go to bed. Like a normal person. You want all your friends at bed.
You want me to tell you something? Maybe you should be a normal mother instead of being the idiot who keeps slapping their own...
Well, maybe you should be a normal son and start listening to your mother when she says it's time for bed. That was over an hour ago. Let's go, because I have to get up in the morning. I've had no sleep these past few nights because of you in here telling you to please get off the computer. Get off. Get off.
First of all, I wasn't...
First of all, I only
I
say
wasn't
it
even
once.
Talking.
I only
when
say
you
it
got
once.
In that bed, I wasn't I, talking.
I don't care. I said I want you in the bed. You have to
Wait,
get up in
the only
morning.
Problem that you've been
You're
complaining about was
You're
that...
Not going.
Okay, fine by me, because we're not going to the water park anyway.
Go to bed. Dad is picking you up in the morning. I told you that.
But you just said I'm not going.
You know what? It will be taken away, and so won't this.
No,
it won't. Well, then get to bed.
Well, first of all, does it even matter if I go? Does it matter?
David wants to see you, and you should spend time with him.
Well, you know what? If you're going to say that, I don't really care that I'm not going, because we're not going to the water park anyway, just because Ashley's having this bullcrap go.
Yeah, you hear that, Ashley? Fuck you. Okay? Fuck your shit, Ashley. I don't want to go to the water park. I want to stay at home and make my mother cry. That's my new objective. Wouldn't let me jack off in peace? Now it's time for blood. Alright, Ashley? I'm not interested in going on the fucking water ride. I'm getting on the little inflatable tubes and shit. I've got a mission. It's to put this bitch 6 feet under. Not getting in the way of that, Ashley. Not gonna happen.
You know what? Stop it.
No!
You know what? First of all, that talk in this house is unacceptable. You don't say the words bullcrap. I'm tired of the way you talk. Your friend talks better than you. He acts better than you. He's nicer to his mother. Do I get that? No. You shit on me all the time. I'm not gonna stop
you
doing
the
things
same
that
things
I...
to me.
Nathan, how do you expect Mom to react to you? You hurt my feelings all the time. You don't listen to me.
Correction, how do you expect
I'm
me...
I'm gonna pop that blackhead.
Correction, how do you expect me
you
to... No! Correction, how do you expect me to answer to you?
Say it nicely, Nathan. Now go to bed, please. Hurry up.
Remember what I said earlier.
I see a lot of people in chat saying he deserves a brutalizing. I don't necessarily disagree, but you have to understand that this is the monster she created. Okay, this helicopter parenting shit that she does has made him this way. Instead of having normal boundaries and a normal lifestyle, she's a single mom and dad's out of the picture, and she doesn't know what the fuck she's doing. And she is absolutely 100% lost control of her son. And he knows it. He's pissed. Like, she wouldn't stop embarrassing him about, you know, getting caught masturbating. And he's out for fucking blood. And she made him like this. And good luck, because he's going to be bigger than her pretty quickly here. And slapping him's not really going to have much of an effect. And it's, again, it comes down to this let's compromise shit. She spent 10 minutes trying to get him to go to bed. She should have just unplugged the fucking computer and thrown his ass in bed. But she didn't think of that. She wants to talk him down from it.
Not the boss, Nathan.
The heck are you talking about?
Nathan,
I am so serious.
You need that.
Do you even know what I'm talking about? That's it.
Go. Right now. I am so tired of this. Shut this thing off.
Well, I have to save it first. God.
You know what, kid? You pushed my button.
Screw you.
Now we're gonna get real here.
Oh, shit's getting real, Chad. Okay, mister. When you told me to piss off, it's go time. I'm gonna take the last possession your father left here before he ran away with that 20-year-old, which is a belt. I'm gonna beat the living shit out of you, buddy.
Okay.
Go to bed.
Bye, mommy. Because guess what? I've been doing lots of workouts and stuff at the Boys and Girls Club this year, so I'm pretty sure I can beat... And remember, before, I knocked you down in less than 5 seconds.
You are not to touch your mother like that. You are to show respect.
Then why are you touching me?
Because, you know what?
Because you're a bad mother.
He legit just said, I can kick your ass. You're right, Chad. He is becoming self-aware. He just told her, try me, bitch. I will win. Try to take me on physically. I'm ready for this. I've been training at the fucking YMCA for the day that we draw blood.
You're a bad son, Nathan. Go to bed. I've had it with you.
Remember, I said I can't go to bed with you around in my room!
And I left.
Then get out right now! I'm so sick of it. Sick of your fat butt in my room. Yeah, stare at me, because you're a little baby and you can't take a tiny insult. Fine!
Shut that thing up right now. You move it. Hurry up.
Kinga, why don't you calm down, fat ass? Why can't you handle an insult, puppy? What's the problem with you? Dad left because you're such a fat piece of shit. Maybe stop eating so many Snicker bars, you tub of pig lard.
Let's go. Hurry up.
I will do it once you get out of my room.
No, right now. Hurry up. Hurry up.
Stop! Get out and I will!
lower your voice.
Get
you don't
out,
talk
and
like
I
that
will.
In my house.
Yes, he's the one that did the same crap.
Hurry up now.
Get out, and I will.
I don't have to get out. Do it right now. You're gonna start showing me.
I will do it once you get out. God, I'm tired of you. You're saying the same stuff. So big deal, right?
Shut it off.
Big deal, you're saying the same stuff.
Here we go.
Why don't you just go to bed if you actually wanted to go to bed? Yeah, I see you. I see you. What do you think I'm doing? Well, you know what? You're the one getting me mad in the first place because you don't understand crap.
Anything that
I said.
Shut that up.
Well,
geez, you're acting like the gorilla mom today.
You're a fucking gorilla. Hey, Tubby, I want you to oink for me, Piggy. Can you oink for me? Can you get your fat ass through that door frame? I see you out there. Maybe we should get some butter and I'll lather your side so you can fit into my room, you fat piece of shit. And let's have a physical throwdown, because I'm ready for it. Listening to this for 14 minutes, lady. You've lost this conversation. This fight is over. He has won this fight. Just walk away. Walk away with some dignity. He basically called you a bitch, said he'll fight you physically. He wants to 1v1 you. And then he said you're fat and a gorilla. Like, just take the loss. Take the L and go.
Shut that up.
Go
ahead.
Okay, what the fuck just happened there?
And I'm sick of you disobeying me.
You don't understand
what
crap.
Did I tell you about that?
You don't understand crap.
Don't talk back to me.
Well, you don't.
I told you that if you listen very well, you'll get your Roblox card. Obviously, you don't want your Roblox card.
And obviously, you don't understand
crap. I told
crap.
You about listening and going to bed on time. I'm tired of you going to bed late. Every
well, no, Nathan,
night
you won't get your
is a
Roblox
big job
card.
With you, and I'm sick of it. I'm going to have Dad set the timer if you don't start listening.
At this point, Nathan turns into your average teenage girl.
Yeah, Dad set the timer.
Yeah, I will.
Dad set the timer. Dad set the timer. Dad do this. Dad do that. He's not your father.
Dad is your father.
He's not yours.
Doesn't matter. He knows how to do all that.
Actually, no. Correction. You're not his mom, so you can't just tell him to do crap like that.
He will do it because he's your father.
God damn it, Nathan.
Now get. You can hear DS in bed. Now go to bed. Go to bed. You can have the DS, or I'll throw the DS out. Take your pick. Enough with the shit.
What?
You're not. Staying up anymore, go to bed. You are getting up early.
Oh,
no, I should have had you go to Auntie Kathy's early. I should be dropping you off in the morning. Auntie Kathy's like, I said, I have to be to work for 7:15. So you could have been getting up at 6 o'clock in the morning.
I don't even care when I wake up. I just want to stay up there.
I should have made you go to bed because she could have babysat you. I'm going to start having babysitters.
No!
You're gonna start getting up early.
No!
Then
I'm not!
Go to bed.
I'm not having a babysitter!
No, I'm gonna have a babysitter.
No!
Then go to bed. You don't start listening.
Yeah, that's a bullcrap choice to make.
I'm gonna have a babysitter. You don't
bullcrap.
Shut that off.
Yeah, you're gonna do a bunch of things that your kid doesn't
want
here.
I'll wake you up at 5, Nathan.
I don't care! I don't care! Make me a five. Like, I'm gonna honestly care.
I said shut that thing out. If I gotta do it.
Stop! Go, and I will!
Shut up.
God! You're an annoying mom! I wish I didn't have you! At this point, I don't even care what the heck is going on. I don't care if you want me to do anything. Oh, wow! Really, Ronaldinator? Really?
Ugh. Ugh. That was something else, chat. I don't know if there, I don't know if there are any others. I swear there were more clips of this kid. Oh my God, is this him?
Hey guys.
Oh my God, this is him. Is this Awesomestrator? Hold on 1 second.
Hey guys, me and my friend Sean here. We are gonna do a video tomorrow.
Oh, no. Okay, this is some different kid who mistakenly picked the worst name possible when it comes to online handles. Oh, I thought that was him for a second. I was like, oh, goddamn. Oh.
Hey, you fuck.
All right. Did you enjoy the Awesomestrator? I saw a lot of people in chat saying, they would have stone cold stunned his ass. They would have devastated him. Again, if you're a parent, the compromising shit doesn't work. You can't sit there for 15 minutes trying to negotiate with your child. You either set the boundary or you're going to have them drive over it in a dump truck and then throw your body in the fucking back cab. Like, did you hear at the end of that? She was so worn down from that 15-minute conversation. She's like, okay, you can go to bed with your DS. She should have walked in there, yanked the fucking power cord from the wall, taken his 3DS and thrown it out the fucking window, and then said, get your ass in bed or I'm throwing you out after that fucking 3DS. You can play the 3DS in the hospital, because that's where you're fucking headed. Somebody in chat, if you ever have kids, beat them, it pays off. Yeah, she lost the battle. Now, I think she brought this on herself because she's just a terrible parent. I should have called this segment Single Mothers. But it's just awful. Negotiations don't get you anywhere. Compromise doesn't get you anywhere. Maybe if they're teenagers, you can compromise. But when they're kids like him, what the fuck are you doing? And if they're 25 like Chibi was, like Adam was, throw them out of the fucking house. It's the same with that Final Fantasy quote kid. Bohepins. He was like 26, 27, didn't want to work a job, played video games all day. Got angry because his grandma told him he's basically a fucking loser, and he couldn't handle it. It's the same story. We keep seeing the same story over and over again. It's weird how that plays out. Jim sounds like a mean dad. I believe in boundaries. That's all. Just some good old-fashioned boundaries. What's that saying? Spare the rod, spoil the child? I think you're looking at a generation of spoiled children. But let's switch it up a little bit. I won't go into depth on this, but we'll watch a little Cosmo. Cosmo's not around anymore. Narcissa Wright has left the building. But there's a compilation up, the Narcissa Delusion. Top crazy moments. I don't know, chat. Do you want to watch a little bit of Narcissus? Do you want to watch a little Cosmo post-op? Watch a few more of these wondrous speedrunners and video gamers. Do the retards want to rise up? Is that what we're doing? Oh, you want me to put up a smasher pass on Narcissa? Okay, since somebody demanded this as a poll. I know Ralph does this every fucking day. let's see how this goes. All right, chat. I just want you to tell me, would you smash your pass on Narcissa? All right, there we go. Let's begin this. Let's do it.
Hey, you fucking old fake fans, you fucking piece of shit. Guess who's playing some Zelda? That's right, the great fucking me. Now go worship me, bitch. I was so far up on the top that I was like in outer space, all right? There is something about me that no one can take away. The consistent number was 10K, 10K, 7K to 10K.
Oh, Cosmo, what the fuck is going on with you, bro? Like, your hair looks all ratty and shit. I don't even... Does Cosmo have cancer? Is there an explanation for why their hair looks like that? I don't fucking know. It just looks horrendous. Everything about this is a train wreck. Like, you could put some effort into it. Maybe go to the store and buy a wig. Make yourself somewhat passable. It looks like you walked out of chemotherapy. Like your doctor just told you you had stage 4 cancer and blasted you with pure plutonium. And your fucking hair is just dying by the minute.
Okay, but I want to surpass everything I've done in the past. It's time to soar to new fucking heights. Human psychology, bullying, attention, fame, the human ego. I've delved into these subjects. I've conducted experiments. I don't regret. It's really hard to sleep under the watchful eye of God.
Oh, it puts the lotion on its skin or else it gets the hose again. What is there? There has to be some correlation, some kind of connection between speedrunning and insanity. I don't know why it is. I don't know what the exact connection is. But let me answer this so we can see what the actual results are. I'm going to pass on this one. It's a hard pass. 62 people said yes. Are you behind on the stream? Are you watching a different portion of it, maybe? Is this coming through properly? Yeah, it is. Oh, boy. Hey, you guys are horny little fuckers. Okay. I don't know what the connection is, but there's something going on.
There's nothing left. Ocarina of Time, any percent. World record in 1915. Set by the great me. Well, okay, here's the thing, though. I never actually slept on stream, though. I only laid down and, like, laid on the bed for, like, 20 minutes or something.
Actually, now that I think about it, how mad do you think Narcissa is about the whole streamy situation? Because after Ralph came here, right, and all these other people started streaming, some people doing 24-hour day streams, you got SBCC... you've got all these other different channels that are popping up that are taking positions on the leaderboard. So they're getting paid out. But I bet for a while there, running a 24-hour stream on Streamy with like 10 people watching put you in the number one position. So Narcissa went from making, what, its first place? Like $650? So $2,600 a month. Narcissa went from making $2,600 a month sleeping on stream to making nothing. $2,600 a month to $0 a month. How fucking mad do you think they are?
World record is subjective. World record is politics. And I'm here to prove it. I'm here to show you the hypocrisy of the term. The hypocrisy of the term. World record, something that seemingly would apply to the entire world, but is actually in the minds of the people. It's in the minds of the people. And I display this to you. I show you. Twitch is very restrictive, and, like, I feel like I'm beyond, like, the style of content that they allow. Like, I'm ready to just, like, break free of it. Some days I'm a super bitch, up to my old tricks, but it won't last forever. And they didn't like that, and so I just left.
It's like a bare room. Like, I imagine Narcissa, like, living in a broom closet that just has a computer and a bed. And that's their everyday. And every day, they depended on that StreamMe weekly contest money. And here comes good old boy, Southern boy Ralph, drinking his whiskey, talking about barbecue, and all the goofy motherfuckers that come with him. And Narcissa goes from, like, first or second place to dead last to leaving the website. And I, you know, just as an aside, I don't think I'm violating StreamMe's policies, because if Narcissa isn't on the site anymore, I can talk about Narcissa. Also, I'm not stream sniping them. I'm watching a YouTube compilation. But that's $2,600 that just disappeared. Ooh, that's not going to lead to pleasant places.
because I think I'm just like ahead of the curve and they're not changing the platform fast enough to meet my needs. Some soul searching might be in order. What do you think I've been doing over the last like 3 years? Like, what do you think?
If I had to guess what you've been doing over the last 3 years, taking way too much estrogen and crying while you Let's Play video games on streaming services? Maybe instead, if you had, I don't know, gotten a job, gone to college, not taken estrogen, and wore dresses in front of people, maybe you'd be in a brighter position right now. Maybe all the bad shit that's going on was brought on by you and your poor life decision-making abilities and skill set. Maybe that's what happened.
I've been fucking doing.
I don't think you should be crying this much when you play Zelda. Like, don't get me wrong. The game's not that difficult, Narcissa. You shouldn't be brought to tears. You should be doing the Bing Bing Wahoo face, right? Open mouth, jumping up and down with your hands waving around. I don't think the appropriate reaction is being brought to tears. I don't know how many people want to watch a Let's Play of fucking Zelda where you've got somebody fucking bawling on screen.
Like, I'm in the middle of, like, crying horrifically vulnerably, and then, like, I get a knock on the door, and there's, like, a group of people who are, like, trying to help people have problems or something. It's like, what the fuck is going on? And then pulling out a gun and killing myself live on stream.
Welcome to the 47%.
I thought about that earlier today.
Like, what do you think I've been fucking doing?
Oh, please support my Patreon, please. Please. I just need another 1500 per month, please. Please support me, please.
It looks like a fucking zombie! Look at that! Holy shit! It looks like a reanimated fucking corpse! I don't think that's edited. That's not like somebody fucking around in Photoshop. That's a direct screen cap. That's Night of the Living Dead shit. That looks, she looks like, Narcissa looks like fucking Nosferatu from a Stephen King movie. Look at the fucking teeth. Holy fucking shit. What a train wreck that person turned into. Narcissa, just fucking go back to calling yourself Cosmo. Alright? Just turn back into a bro. And I think your problems will resolve themselves. Oh, let's see if we can find some more. Should we look for a little more on Narcissa? I don't know what we're gonna find. A lot of people did like compilation videos. Oh. Oh, I'm sorry. I became so afraid of Narcissa, I accidentally had my fucking headset muted. Terrifying. Terrifying. Wokimosabi, the spirit of Danga has come back. I'll press F, chat. I've been possessed. I've been possessed by Kimosabi. No, but if you want to watch it, it's 4chan V bullies Narcissa. I've taken the poll down. 73 of you want to bang this. I don't know what the fuck to tell you. Just shameful. Just shameful. Alright, let me get this queued up. I don't know if it's any good. Somebody thought it was good enough to put the whole thing up, so we'll take a look. We will take a fucking look. Alright, let's do it. Let's go. Ugh, okay, I'm gonna skip ahead to see where we get to the Frankenstein pictures here. Is this the right stream? I want to see something. I don't want to just watch them scroll through this. Oh, okay, this one's a bust. Not everyone's gonna be a winner. Not everyone's gonna be a winner. Let's back that out. You know what, actually, fuck it, we'll watch this. I you know, I'm actually kind of fucking surprised. I forgot about this.
$50 from Anonymous.
Alright, let's... speaking of Chibi Necodemics, there was another clip I cannot believe I fucking let this slip my mind. So we heard the internet calling his mother about the penis pictures, the pizzas getting delivered, mommy yelling at him about Let's Playing too late into the night. But he actually came to some prominence in a clip from SGDQ from 2014. Let's take a look at that one. Let us take a look at that one.
$50 from Anonymous. Here's $50 for the most awkward moment.
If you ever wondered who that annoying guy that got told to shut up was, that's Chibi.
Welcome back, guys. We're just getting ready for the next game.
This looks fun.
Oh, it is. 3, 2, 1, go. Hello, everyone. I am CavemanDCJ, and this is Tomba 2. Oh, that's a good start.
Well, I mean, it's more a plot than Bubsy has. It's weird, I always usually wear pajama pants, but I would say I wear jeans today.
Yeah, you're not dressed for the occasion.
I'm not.
Yeah, me neither.
Neither.
I recommend all viewers to go get a nice cup of Joe, perhaps a bagel.
Dude, I love bagels.
Just sit back.
Yeah, Wild smiled in the chat. The annoying guy is also a confirmed cheater. Yeah, earlier in the stream, we were watching Adam footage of his house getting bombed by pizzas and somebody calling his mommy up about him sending dick pics to underage girls. And now we're tying it back in. We're bringing it back. It's a callback, right? And this is him. And not only did he get busted for cheating, but he's really fucking annoying in person, too.
And enjoy some breakfast, Tomba.
Asiago cheese bagel? Yummy.
I believe you.
This game definitely has an interesting playstyle to it.
How do you mean?
Well, like, most games in this kind of style are like sort of 2D scroll or 3D scrollers, whereas this one is kind of have a lot, has another dimension to it.
Yeah, it's like 2.5D.
2.5Ds, yeah. Yeah, this
get used to this song if anyone's listening.
Yeah.
The character design of this game kind of reminds me of Adventure Island.
Alright.
Here's my great insight to this. And then he's just like, yeah, alright, shut up. Will somebody get this guy off the couch? Get him off the couch. Bring me the guy that smells chairs. I'd rather have him sitting next to me. Please get this person out of the fucking building.
This is an amazing time for donations, like just this game in general.
All right, well, we have $20 from iNiffy. Here's $20. You can have it. Maybe it'll come in useful. And we have $5 from...
We're not going to, because I like the boomerang.
Boomerang hype?
Hype?
So this is the case where getting crabs is a good thing?
Yeah.
I've never seen crabs used that way.
And you won't ever again. That is the end of the crab section of the ROM.
Rip crabs. Yes! Fast pants.
They make you go fast.
I want one now.
Equipment that you...
I love the dead silence. He can't pick up on it. It's like his mom said, he has autism. He's on the spectrum. He can't pick up on the subtle hint that nobody wants to talk to him. And they all want him to be quiet. And that poor fucker with that 70s porn stash in the pajama pants, having a Tourette's moment next to him, playing the fucking game. It's just boiling over inside. Just wants to turn around and smack him.
Pick up.
Oh yeah, I would hate to actually, like, have to put the pants on.
I mean...
Alright, rip safety, Apple. I gotta go.
I mean, I could always wear the pants.
We have $10 from Zarganian, and he says he's gotta give some money for his bro Chibi on the couch right now, and get him some birthday hype.
Hey, thanks, Zarganian.
We have $20 from Eoin, Tombi Squirrel Suit Hype, donating another $5 if the announcer can pronounce my name right. Hopefully I was close.
Oh yeah, this game is called Tombi with an I.
No, Eoin, the donator. But I pronounced both of you wrong, forgive me.
I prefer Tomba, it makes him sound more masculine.
Does.
I mean, he has pink hair, so he is a true man.
My name is Tomba the Mighty.
He doesn't actually talk, though. So he...
It's just... Yeah. It reminds me, like, there were clips on Jocktober with Opie and Anthony where they would talk about radio shows where there's no chemistry and how one guy would go for a joke and the other would kill it immediately right there. And that's what Pornstash is doing. Every time Jimmy tries to open his dumb fucking mouth, Pornstash is like, yeah, no. All right, shut up. Yeah, no, I'm not interested in that. Stop. It's just, it's fucking, it's like secondhand cringe. It's almost painful to watch.
Would never say that in any situation.
He makes grunts. That's kind of like talking.
He could pretend he does.
I have fast pants.
We get turbo pants later.
Now you're just making me excited.
Yeah, I don't think you're ready for that.
I don't think I am. I think I need some time to prepare my body.
He's so muscular, he just felt no change in his weight.
And Tomba just proceeded to put him in his pants.
Well, yeah, I got fast pants.
Never doubt the powers of weapon space.
Alright.
Somebody said mustache guy is just as bad. I mean, you're correct. But Chibi Adam, when he's there, he's such a focal point for autism. That it directs all attention in the room onto him. That even the other autists are, like, giving him looks. Like, really? This fucking guy? Really?
From Brendan 3, love Tomba 2. I never fully beat it as a kid and just managed to beat it for the first time a couple of years ago. You've made my workday so much better.
Someone else has a birthday today.
What are the odds?
Right? It's kind of coincidental how, like, in most games, pigs are evil.
Such as?
Well, Diddy Kong Racing, Zelda, Mother.
Thank you for the list of evil pigs in video games.
You're welcome. Dude, how come I never saw this Christmas special as a kid?
You can see the hate developing. Like, he's getting there. We're getting to the good part. Like, it's just, he wants to fucking strangle him.
It's a rare game, I guess, really. 300, I thought it was like 60. Well, like new, I guess.
Yeah, necessary.
Space pig. It's the greatest trick.
Since when did Super Mario Brothers U get here?
Good joke.
So, confirmed Santa's number one helper is a squirrel.
I would really prefer if you would be quiet.
Look at his face! Look at that! Look at the face! He looks like he got fucking punched! Let's back that up. Just watch really closely. Pay real close attention to his face as he says this. It's glorious.
I would really prefer if you would be quiet.
Did you see that? It's not even... There's not like a transition! It just goes from happy to sad. It's like somebody filmed this at like 14 frames per second and we're missing footage. It's just, it's instant. His face just collapsed.
But yes, you are correct.
$10 from Dracu. The Tom V2 was my favorite childhood game, so I just had to get it for the first time.
Thank you so much for the run and good luck.
Best thing about it is he's stuck there. So after this awkward moment where he's basically told to shut the fuck up, he's on the couch. He's got to stick through it till the end of the fucking playthrough. He can't just run away. Oh, I fucking love the internet sometimes. Some of the shit, I'm telling you, some of the shit that's out there, it's great. It's good stuff. Really good stuff. You know, now I was going to have that Chibi Iwata funeral footage for you, but I actually ended up watching it, and it's awful. It's awful in a non-funny way. Like, there's bad funny, and then there's just bad bad. And that Iwata funeral is just bad bad. It's 30 minutes of soul-sucking nothingness. It's watching a fucking sped of the age of 25 in his mother's basement, just solemnly speaking about a dead Japanese man he's never met. I mean, I'm sure there's some comedy in there, but damned if I could find it. I tried. I did. So I was thinking, what are we going to talk about this morning? You know, in between my video game sessions, what are we going to talk about if I were to stream? And I thought, well, there's some chibi videos we could check out. His trip to Comic-Con or whatever gay shit he went to. Him trying to shave and looking like he was going to cry doing it. The shave. Ugh, a shirtless Chibi shaking as he shaves himself. I guess it's a terrifying prospect to a neckbeard to shave themselves. Oh, and he's a smart boy, too. He puts on the shaving cream before he takes his shirt off. That's a genius move. It's a 30-minute video. I don't know how many men are in the audience. I'd assume there are a few. But I'm going to guess the majority of you understand that, you know, shaving doesn't take 30 fucking minutes. It's a pretty quick process. It's not like he's dry shaving. He's not in the fucking military. This guy's not part of the French Foreign Legion. But somehow he works out how to milk that fucking event for 30 minutes. So we'll watch some of that. All right, let me pull down our bro here, the shield hero, teaching bitches. He's thought patrolling in a fantasy setting. Glorious. Now, let me get everything set up and we'll jump into that. Now, this is directly from Chibi's page too, by the way. Because of course, what man who doesn't know how to shave himself wouldn't put that up on his YouTube channel? Okay. I think we are good to go. I think we're good to go. Display capture. There we are. And I'll leave that up actually. The shave warning may contain cringe. Just got to give you a heads up. This may be uncomfortable for everybody. Well, let's take a look and see what this goofy fuck does before we jump into the fat people in unreasonably fitting costumes.
You guys have not witnessed true autism yet.
Rosecat, there's like a 10-minute limit on Nightbot.
All right, here we go.
Can't request songs that are more than 10 minutes.
Oh my god, it's like a freaking solid ass mass. There we go.
Are you sponsored by Schaller Dollar Shave Club?
Dollar Shave Club.
He almost said Schaller.
Maybe Chibi's like ahead of the curve here. You know, Peterson got really popular on the internet recently with his whole wash your dick bucko shit. Because there's so many young adult men that need surrogate fathers because they don't know how to groom themselves. And here's Chibi doing the very first Let's Groom on YouTube. Look, Dr. Peterson, I washed my penis, now I'm gonna shave my face. See? I slayed the fucking dragon.
Shaller.
I wanna see nothing but cringe in the chat right now.
Shaller Dave Club.
I wanna see nothing but the word cringe.
Oh, boy, that too!
Let's go back to 2014, boys.
That's correct, chat. Shave your penis. That's what he really needs to do.
One does not simply cringe.
Can you tell?
Turn the volume down on this shit.
Look how long this motherfucker's taken to put on that shit. This is not that difficult. He should have been done in 3 seconds. This asshole is like he's spackling a wall or something. Like he's doing construction. You could tell he's never shaved before with the amount of time he's dedicated to this shit.
Didn't.
Wait. Rose Cat brings up a point. You have to do it shirtless as well.
Oh, shit. You're right.
People want me to speed it up? Well, I mean, I could try. We could try double speed. Maybe that'll make it more bearable. It's still slow as shit. Now he's just acting like a normal human. He's starting to get normal people speed, and I had to double the speed on it. So you just put it all over your face. I don't see a razor in sight. Maybe he thinks a fucking cream magically takes the hair off. Maybe it's Nair. Anybody remember that product women used to use? They'd slather themselves in that shit, and it would dissolve the hair and take off like 4 layers of skin.
Oh no.
Me controller. I'm glad I have my mystery. So what's on right now?
Megalovania.
Oh yeah.
Okay. Does that actually count as cringe though?
Shit, I got way too much fucking foam on my hand.
He's got too much foam on his hand. This motherfucker, how does he function in life? Maybe his mommy shaves him. Maybe she does everything else for this guy. Deals with people calling the house about him sending out cock pics to people.
It's not even close.
I like that commercial.
Did you expect anybody shaving on stream in the first place?
Now, he grabbed that electric cord, in case you're wondering what's going on, to strangle himself, because he doesn't want to be a big boy and shave his disgusting neck beard. So, this is how the police are going to find the body. There's just some dude with white shit all over his fucking face hanging from an electric cord. He's pulling a David, oh my god, what the fuck is his name? The Kung Fu guy. The Kung Fu guy that used to asphyxiate himself for sexual pleasure and took it too far one day.
Because we reached 275 subs and Gray Lane is an actual monster.
I mean, this is
and so is Freezer, and so is Rosecat. This is all your fault.
But not Umbreon's cool.
I thought you were only 9 subs that followed them.
Only 9.
Like, 50?
Yeah, you know what, yeah, granted, there were like at least 50.
Hey, would you like this
video again? Oh my god, your boy won. This is Shaller Dave Club Bear sponsor Quanta.
Shaller Dave Club.
Oh my god.
Yes.
So, is this going into the Cringe compilation too?
Oh, always.
Of course.
Is this going to be on YouTube, actually? I'd love to see that.
Probably.
Okay, let me slow it down, because we got to the... This is the money shot. I hope you're ready, chat. It only took him 5 minutes of prep work to get the fucking shit on his face. Let's see how the shaving actually goes.
Give me the... Dude, that'd be freaking hilarious.
Son of a bitch.
I just want to point out, I'm playing the most...
Why this song?
Not crazy one.
Why this
hey,
song?
Would you...
No!
Would you actually...
Dude!
Has it hit any of you that you're awake at... Well, my time, 6 in the morning, watching an autistic man try to shave his face. What has happened to your life, chat? Why are you watching this?
I think I started the Kiss of Vaporeon
business
again.
If I don't do
again.
This, people are gonna bitch, whatever.
Yeah, I'm gonna be honest. I was just...
What fucking ever, dude.
Hey, so could you bring in the
Shaving pro tip number 1 for anybody out there that's never done it before. Always put the shaving cream on, and then take your shirt off.
Gotta ask him. Come on, depend on us. Oh my god, he actually did it.
Okay, you can go away now.
You actually did
it. It's one thing to meme, it's another thing to actually be a flat-out fucking dick.
Whoa, what's going on?
Alright, you're gone.
Whoa, what the shit?
You hear the exclamation of his autistic friends, shocked by the fact that you can remove hair from yourself. I didn't know you could do that. Chibi, thank you for showing us. I need to go shave my penis for Dr. Peterson.
Dear lord, that is
yeah,
a lot
I,
of fucking
I just
hair.
Took a look at what that one guy said.
That is a lot of fucking hair. Come on with this fucking music right now.
Wait, what's playing?
Do you see? I want you to pay really close attention to his hand. This is how you know this dirty fuck has never shaved before. He's acting like it's a straight razor. Like he's gonna gouge himself to death with it. It's very, very shaky.
Tra-la-la.
So,
oh my god.
I have a question. Does the song request have to be Cringe too, or is that not able?
It doesn't have to be.
Okay, because I requested some video game music.
We're just sort of meaning.
Hey,
right
I requested
now.
Crazy Frog, okay?
You
oh,
did
god.
What now?
Crazy
oh,
Frog!
God.
Oh my god.
So, how's the shaving coming, Akora?
Just fine, thanks for asking.
Just kiss the big boy.
La 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 la.
Maybe
yeah,
do
how's
a...
that one sound go?
Maybe do a 15.
In honor of Ralph and his never ending smash or pass polls, I put one up for you guys.
Hey.
Every 50 subs, he kisses.
Who is that? Someone's very.
Why he's shaving? It's because of you, Gray.
Is Kenny talking?
I don't know.
What do you mean?
Okay, I thought I heard someone talking and they were very.
People go nuts from watching me shirtless.
Is it Rose, can you talk to me?
You seriously suck at this? OMG, I hate watching this. Then why are you here?
Why are you watching me shave myself on Twitch TV? I don't know. I mean, I like to go to the zoo and watch monkeys fling shit at each other too, Chibi. There's something appealing about watching retards be retards. Look at what he's doing! What the fuck is this? How can a man have this much difficulty shaving himself? Oh, Jesus Christ, Zoomers, what the fuck?
I don't usually use a hand shaver. Yeah, edit the song requests, because I'm pretty sure there's a few, like, awful ones in there.
Hey, Quanta, this is a really weird Jackbox mod. What mod is this?
You know, I don't know. I don't know. This is, Cringe Simulator 2018.
Oh, nice.
Okay, thanks, Game Crazy.
Oh, that unsteadiness in his hand. He's so nervous. I better get shaved. I better get shirtless and shave myself on Twitch. That's what those video game fans want. The hotness. Come on, chat. Smash or pass. You tell me.
Not a single Aquana W I see.
You know you've just ruined that.
Yeah, you did.
You know you immediately jinxed yourself as soon as
you
said that.
You actually did. That is entirely your fault.
That was the plan. That
was
the plan.
Was it?
It was.
I like to imagine, because he's not doing this in the bathroom, that this is just in the basement, and he's just dropping the fucking disgusting hair on the floor for his mother to sweep up later on. No wonder she's always in a bad mood. Just whatever. Mommy can clean it up. I don't need to dispose of this disgusting byproduct of my unhealthy lifestyle. Mommy will get it.
I got the pyramid!
This is the most interesting sub goal I've ever encountered.
Yeah.
Somebody brought up his razor. I bet that's his mom's Bic that she uses for vagina maintenance. Like when she gets all nice and smooth so Tyrone will help raise her autistic son. And he just grabbed it from the bathroom. He grabbed it right from the bathroom, mommy's special razor, and he's just dragging it across his fucking face. That's how you get herpes, Chibi.
Are the blades any good? No.
Our blades are f***ing great.
Each razor has stainless steel blades and aluminum lubricating strip, pivot head. It's so gentle a toddler could use it.
It just sounds weird when people say
spending $20 a month on brand name razors. 19 go to Roger Federer.
Like, it just looks a lot more.
Do you think your razor needs a vibrating handle, a flashlight, a back scratcher, and 10 blades? Your handsome ass grandfather had one blade and polio.
Yeah, we're 13 minutes into his 29-minute shaving extravaganza. He looks like a hobo that got caught in a box fire. How is he having this much? He doesn't understand how shaving cream works. You can see the confusion on his face. Why isn't the hair coming off in a uniform manner? Why do I have little patches everywhere? Look at him. He's so sad. Why do I have to groom myself? Why does Dr. Peterson keep telling me to wash my testicles?
Is this actually a legit DollarShaveClub.com? Also, Watnass is on. This.
Then I see the root sandstorm. Okay, we already have boots.
Why not? That actually looks like a real legit commercial.
Chat, where is this dude's dad? Where would you be if this was your son? If your fucking son was half naked in the basement shaving for his friends on the internet for the past 14 minutes. Probably at the liquor store. Probably at the liquor store buying a bottle of whiskey to drown out the memories that this is his offspring.
Wait, community controller, what are they playing now?
They've been playing Breath of the Wild.
Oh my god, is that even physically possible?
I mean, they've got 10 hearts.
What's being played?
Breath of the Wild.
By who?
More foam short stroke.
People in chat saying that his father's dead. No, that was just the cover story. That's what he told people to get the fuck out of Dodge. Oh, honey, I'm having a heart attack. I'm not going to be able to raise Chibi. It's all on you, baby. Just don't let him get your special vagina pic. He'll drag it across his face for a half an hour on Twitch.
I don't think it's physically possible to do
that. I think they tried Fortnite, but it didn't work out.
Yeah, I mean, you can't really...
Hey, there's also just doing it for the fun of it, regardless of how it's going to be, you know?
It took us a week
just
to
out of curiosity,
our
out of morbid curiosity, how did Fortnite go?
I mean, pay much attention to it.
It's mostly just one
50v50.
Overhyped game, in my opinion.
Yo, what's up,
It looked like a lot of just pretty much moving was like at like 0.1 miles.
Watching him shave is like watching somebody that doesn't understand how cars work try to fucking problem solve a reason why their vehicle won't start in the morning. You know what I mean? Like, they don't understand the parts to an engine or how a vehicle functions. So it's a fucking mystery to them. They just start digging into shit. They think the windshield wiper fluid has something to do with the battery. That's him right now. That's him and the mystery of shaving. He just doesn't understand any of it.
I feel like Square Enix would make hella money if they put Kingdom Hearts on Switch.
They're already playing it on Xbox PlayStation.
I mean, like, I know
they're gonna make hella money already.
I don't think Kingdom Hearts 3 can work on Switch, but I know 1.5, 2.5, they would make hella bang just doing that.
Dude, being able to play...
That's a very good observation. Somebody in chat, look how none of his friends are correcting him. No, none of them understand. These are all the products of single mothers. He had an electric razor? Why did you wait to use it? What the fuck are you doing? This is just awful.
It does look pretty
slick. Auto-view, skate crazy.
So...
He's like Tom Sawyer painting that fence, just half-assing it the whole way. Look at him, just dragging it across. There's no rhyme or reason. He's not going for coverage, or, you know, to have it look nice and neat and clean. It's a fucking shotgun approach to shaving. I don't think he understands what he's doing at all.
Pretty good.
Is it worth the $60 though?
You mean Mario Aces?
Yeah. I mean, it depends if you're a fan of tennis.
Yeah, I never actually played the tennis games before.
Of course, Kidlink's gonna say Ace is amazing because he plays tennis.
Now, what the chat doesn't know, his live audience is unaware of, is that our little twink Chibi here is going to take all his facial hair that he's collected on the floor as like a little rat nest, and then glue it to his chest later so he doesn't look like a prepubescent boy when he takes his shirt off in front of people in the future.
Just follow this. You need a really nice, robust tart. What we're looking for is a really nice, broad, the most popular bird in the country, flexible
body,
semi-firm breasts, but quite bouncy. And then just lift up the skirt, and they get excited, so they look wet.
That exists.
Open up the legs, two beautiful thighs, three fingers.
For some reason.
Get your hand, and always treat your hand like a sort of whisk. Push
that
your fingers in there,
never
and it's nice and moist, and smelling very fragrant. And that confirms she's ready for up and down motion. That's not rocket science, is it? That's common
sense.
So what's
the next sub goal?
Don't be scared of that. Don't worry.
I'm sort of amazed that it could, you know, a human being, a male, and he's not like, this isn't a teenage boy. This isn't like some 13 or 14 year old boy that's never shaved before and doesn't understand how it works and is going to be a little goofy at first. This is a 25 year old man. A 25 year old man whose hands are shaking. Like he's going to have sex for the first time or something. Just completely out of his element. Just dragging that shit across his face. Use mommy's special vagina razor. Get that infection nice and deep. Then grabs daddy's old electric razor, the only thing he left in the house when he fled, to fucking finish the job. He's got this fucking deformed mutton chops going on. Hair's half sticking on his face. Oh, Chibi, Jesus fucking Christ.
Any other games gonna be stressed?
Yes, actually.
And then bang.
Yeah, we're gonna play a different Jackbox game.
It pops out. You get to release it from the bottom and just drip. Yeah. A really nice, white, creamy liquid down the bottom to give it some form of decoration.
Oh my god,
just
okay.
Almost like a little tap,
okay, go
and just let it drizzle out.
Wait
now,
a minute.
Don't touch your face, this especially your eyes. Jackbox. It smells like a fish. It's strong.
They're actually ruining Gordon Ramsay for me by playing that over this horrendous shit. As somebody else mentioned with the giant fucking circular headphones that he's got on right now. Yeah, he's probably going to have... You know where his sideburns are? He's going to have a giant circle of hair left. Because I bet he's too dumb to fucking remove the headphones to shave that portion. He better lather up my shoulders. That's important. With my electric razor. Get that shaving cream on there. Oh. You know, watching stuff like this, I got to say, it makes me feel a little bit better. Because no matter how bad things get, at least I know what the fuck I'm doing when it comes to shaving my own goddamn face. But poor Chibi here is just, he's lost in the thickets of it. Better keep the mustache, though. That's what gets the ladies wet. We gotta get rid of the neckbeard, but that rockin' 70s porn stash, that's gotta stay. Okay, that's my saver flavor. Or that's my flavor saver. That's important to keep on my face. I think if in your video game career you've reached the point of shaving on stream for your three autistic friends on Skype, it's probably time to shut it down. Maybe time to do something else. Maybe go into movie reviews or anime or something. But I think at this point, I think it's time to call it a day. Just to walk away from the whole business of Let's Playing and speedrunning. Because clearly your audience is just disgusted with you. Oh, okay, let me pause that for a second. Get that off the screen. Oh, Jesus. Two-thirds of the way through, we're not watching the rest of this. I think he's mastered the mystery of removing hair from his face. It only took us a good 21 fucking minutes. 21 minutes of Chibi struggling to work a fucking razor. You know, not surprising to me that he thought if he took a dog collar off, he would die. Not surprising to me that he told a girl online, "I want you to watch a man fuck me." Not surprising to me that he'd send dick pics to underage kids. Not surprising at all. Watching him struggle with this, it's starting to make sense why he makes such poor life decisions. Again, the product of a single mother. Women, if you're a single mother out there, invest in buying a belt. You're going to need it. In fact, buy a nice leather belt with a really hard metallic belt buckle and just have the name Dad embroidered on it so you can pull that fucker out anytime you need it so your kid doesn't end up like Chibi Necodemics here. And you're not getting phone calls from people on the internet in the middle of the night saying, hey, your son is sending his penis pictures to underage kids. Oh, I see somebody in chat. I just finished shaving right now. Did it take you 29 minutes? Did you beat Chibi's time? I mean, he is a speedrunner, so I guess he put that up on a website as a record. You should challenge that record. I was able to do it in 2 minutes, because I'm not retarded. I don't think Chibi's ever going to take that crown from you. I think this is the fastest competitive time for shaving he's ever put up.
Hello, everyone. Today, we as a gaming community have suffered a great loss. The cause was a cancerous bile growth tumor. He is succeeded by his wife. Like the saying goes, one can never truly appreciate something until it's gone. While his life may have been cut short, the legacy he left will still resonate with us for generations. And even though he was never with us when he spoke, it was clear that he was speaking not only to us, but directly to our hearts. I'll now sing a song from Earthbound called I Believe in You. I believe the morning sun always gonna shine again, and I believe a pot of gold waits at every rainbow's end. Oh, I believe in roses kissed with dew. Why shouldn't I believe the same in you? I believe in make-believe, fairy tales and lucky charms, and I believe in promises spoken as you cross your heart. Oh, I believe in skies forever blue. Why shouldn't I believe the same in you? You may say I'm a fool, feeling the way that I do. You can call me Pollyanna, say I'm crazy as a loon. I believe in silver linings, that's why I believe in you. I believe there'll come a day. Maybe it'll be tomorrow when the bluebird flies away. All we have to do is follow. I believe a dream can still come true. Still, that's why I believe in you. You may say I'm a fool, feeling the way that I do. I believe in friends and laughter and the wonders love can do. I believe in songs and magic, and that's why I believe in you. We'll now take this time to allow other fans to talk about how his influences changed their lives. I have a few people with me today that are wanting to share a few things.
Alright, I'm not dead, but I swear to God, I wish I fucking was.
Okay then.